Alright, we're gonna start with our dead dog, we're gonna go breathing. So first thing you're gonna go knees bent, 90 degrees, arms straight up. And what you're gonna do is breathe in through your diaphragm or in through your stomach. Just nice deep breaths, keeping your low back flat to the floor. You're gonna do five. Once you're done with five, you're gonna hold this same position and you're gonna keep knees bent, just tap your heels down towards the floor. Biggest thing here is that we are keeping our low back flat to the floor, not getting an arching through our hips. Once you've done five on each side, all you're gonna do is straighten your leg and now extend. Same thing here, keeping that low back flat. If as you're doing this, you feel like your back is arching, go ahead and keep your legs bent. And that is perfectly acceptable so that we are working on our core here. And then once you're done with the straight legs, we're gonna go opposite arm and leg. So both are going to extend. And again, just keeping that low back flat to the floor, think belly button in towards your spine. This is all focusing on warming up our core, being stable in through our core. You're gonna go five with everything. This should all build off of each other. Once you're done with those, go ahead and flip on over. We're gonna go front planks and side planks. Just a couple things I wanna point out with these ones. When you are doing a front plank, you wanna make sure that we've got shoulders, elbows in a nice straight line. So elbows tend to drift forward. Make sure that we keep elbows right underneath our shoulders. Press up away from the floor so that we've got a nice round in through our upper back. Squeeze your glutes so that we're tucking our hips. Core stays nice and tight here again, belly button up towards your spine. Good, you're gonna hold 30 seconds and then we're gonna go to a side plank. Same idea with our side plank. We want elbow directly underneath our shoulder and then make sure that your hips are aligned. So one thing that's a common thing to do here, and see if I can do this for me, is top hip is gonna rotate back and this opens everything up and puts a lot of pressure on that shoulder joint. So we've gotta make sure that we're keeping our hip forward. You should feel this in your obliques. If you're feeling this in your shoulder, chances are we need to rotate those hips forward a little bit more. 30 seconds on each side. Relax, and then we're gonna go into our glute bridges. So we're just warming up kind of everything into our core here. Knees bent, heels into the floor, really dig heels in. What you're gonna do, think about almost like rolling up into this position. So we're not arching our back, we're squeezing our glutes, we're just gonna go back and forth. And think about squeezing glutes at the top every single time. You might not get all the way up when you're doing your glute bridges, and that is okay. We really want to make sure that we are tucking our hips underneath, not arching, so that we're actively using our glutes. Right, you're gonna go 25, and then when you're done, go ahead and lay on your side. We're gonna do some AB and AB adduction, so basically warming up our glutes and our groin. So first thing, shoulders, hips, knees, ankles all in a nice straight line, top leg is going to lift up, and you are just going to make some circles in both directions. Now, basically doing a nice job here of keeping your toe pointed down towards the floor. What can happen with this is if you rotate that toe up, we tend to rely more on that hip flexor, and we wanna make sure that we're putting that in our glutes. So keeping that toe down is going to make sure that we're using our right muscles. You're gonna go both directions on both sides, and then you're gonna do the same thing with your bottom leg. So you're gonna bend this top leg, and then basically lift this leg up off the floor and make circles. Try and get up as high as you can towards the ceiling. That's really gonna activate your groin muscles as we're just warming up and stabilizing our hips. Circles in both directions. And again, you're gonna do that on both legs. Go ahead and stand up when you're done with those. You're gonna go shifting lateral lunges. So feet out nice and wide. Yeah, let's go toes forward. You're gonna reach your hip back. Now, biggest thing with the lateral lunge here, you want weight on your heels, knees should be in line with your ankles, hips back, shoulders up. This looks really good. You're gonna hold this position and just shift side to side. If you feel unbalanced, and chances are your feet are in too close, so just go ahead and widen your feet up. All right, so this looks really good here. You're gonna go 10 in each direction, and then we're gonna go squat to hamstring with the rotation. All right, so feet, position so that you can keep your feet flat. Okay? Sometimes you tend to get more range of motion if we shift up here, but we want to make sure that feet are staying flat. And then you're going to rotate. Use your elbow against that knee to really kind of drive that hip open. Rotate up, look up towards that hand, and then you're going to come up and stretch out hamstrings in between. If you can hold on to your toes, that's great. You can give a nice stretch in through our hamstrings. We're just going to go back and forth. Rotate. Both sides, good. And then come up, stretch out our hamstrings. Good. Five there. Once you're done, we're gonna go forward. challenge. So with this, working on warming up our legs and a little bit of balance in between. So you want to make sure that we don't set our foot down and you're transitioning straight from that forward lunge into our reverse lunge. Using our arms, make sure we've got opposite arm motions here, and then good 90-degree angles at our knees, hips, ankles, and both times. You're gonna do that on both sides. We've got single leg RDLs next. We'll work on a little bit of balance here too. Standing leg, slightly bent. Okay, make sure weight is back towards our heels as much as we can. All the way up, good. That's really good balance. Going back and forth. And then we want to work on controlling our hips. So we want to keep our hips nice and square and that we're not rotated open. Yep, so good. Come all the way up. You should feel a nice stretch into your hamstring as you are doing this. And again, just challenging our balance as well. Mountain climbers, just getting our heart rate up. So good plank position, drive your knees up. We're just going to go 25 on each side. Try to stay nice and light on your feet. Once we're done with those, we've got just a few plyos. We're going to go single leg forward hops. You're going to start in a good athletic position, so knees bent, hips back, shoulders up, and make sure we're kind of in that quarter squat position. From here, we're going to hop forward, but we're going to really challenge our balance, and we're going to go eyes closed. Good. Hop forward, just a small hop, working on that balance, okay? You are not going to be good at this right away, and that's fine. What we really want to do is just fight for that balance every single time. And you're going to go the same thing, going lateral and medial, so I'll show you what those look like. Same starting position. Lateral is just going off to the side. Again, we're keeping our eyes closed, and then medial will be going back the other direction. So you're just going to do five on each side of that, and that is our day one, week one warm-up.